I am Stella Gambino. Welcome to Atomic TV's Let's Be Safe, the segment that'll plunge your genitals into ice-cold water and send a shiver down your sinful little spine. Today's segment, Our Friend the Condom. Yeah, well, we're here to tell you about safe sex. I know it sounds pretty bland and passionless, but you don't have to be Catholic to know that sex isn't supposed to be fun. Ask any defrocked priest and he'll tell you, sex will get you into trouble. Now, if God wanted us to play with our thingies, we'd lick them all day long like dogs and cats. It's very unhygienic. Nope, instead he gave us sex so that dermatologists and shrinks could earn a healthy living. It also gave us sex as another sneaky way to try and kill us. Don't forget, we're living in the age of the AIDS, and you gotta be careful of HIV splashback every time you flush a public urinal. That's why I'm here to scare you kids into simmering down your overheated sex organs. You gotta keep it in your pants or at least hang a towel over it. By the time I'm through with you, you'll be so scared of doing the dirty deed with uncovered genitalia, you'd rather shove your penis in a jar full of hungry-mouthed maggots or ram a hornet's nest up your uterus. Maybe you think I lack a little credibility in this. Just think of me as a fallen angel trying to steer you from a burning lake of fire, which is what your pee's gonna feel like if you don't watch out. We're going to talk about the condom, the rubber, the jimmy, the love glove, the Coney Island whitefish, what have you. Anyhow, it's our only protection in the war against STC, sexually transmitted cooties. I'm holding up a Trojan Magnum Gold, extra large. Thanks, Tom.
No problem, Stella. That's what I'm here for. Anytime, baby.
And that's appropriate, because I'm going to show you a film of a Trojan factory, an exclusive boys' club where cooties are not allowed.
Welcome to the Trenton, New Jersey manufacturing plant for Trojan latex condoms. We'll take you through the entire manufacturing process. From the time the raw material, the latex, is compounded at the plant through the packaging of the final product, the Trojan condom that you know and trust. The latex used for manufacturing condoms is a natural material derived from the rubber plant. In its original form, the latex is a white liquid that has the consistency of milk. It is stored in drums for a day or so, during which time the latex is tested to ensure that it conforms to Trojan's standards. This is generally known as the feeding room, where the latex is fed into the manufacturing line. Glass formers called mandrels are dipped into the liquid latex. Glass is used because it coats smoothly, helping to prevent defects from forming on the surface and permits easy removal from the mandrel. Then the mandrels are lifted so that the first coat of latex can dry. The dipping and drying procedure is repeated a second time, and in the case of colored condoms like Trojan Plus, the pigmented latex is applied in the second dipping. These condoms have a reservoir tip end found on most Trojan condoms. Next, the rim or ring of the latex condom is formed by the action of two cylinders which pick up the film and roll it onto itself, forming a ring. The cylinders roll the latex to the length of 7.5 inches, the industry standard length for condoms. Quality control and testing are of primary importance. Bob Lauer is manager of the Trojan plant.
Trojan brand condoms that are manufactured here in Trenton are all electronically tested, 100%. The test consists of a condom being placed on a stainless steel mandrel that is 15% larger than the condom itself. This additional stretch enables us to pick out even a small pinhole. The condom and mandrel then conveyed through a water bath where an electronic charge is placed on the bath to the mandrel. If the circuit is complete, then that indicates there's a defect and the condom is rejected. The reject mechanism consists of an air cylinder which is tripped by this completed circuit. And then when the condom reaches the takeoff stage, it is automatically put into a reject bin.
The air inflation test consists of inflating a latex condom at a standard rate, which is 25 liters per minute. Then the breaking strength is recorded. The minimum breaking strength allowed is 1 kilopascal over the breaking volume of 25 liters. This is the industry standard and also the international standard. Trojan brand condoms consistently inflate to a higher volume before breaking. Another one of the tests performed is the water leakage test, which is simply filling the condom with 300 milliliters of water and checking for pinholes. Also conducted is the tensile and elongation test, which measures the percent elongation and the breaking strength. This is one of the most important tests for measuring the characteristics of the finished product. In the case of Trojan brand condoms, they will stretch at least 7.5 times their original length. Following these rigorous quality control tests, the condoms are prepared for lubrication and continue to the foiling stage. A final inspection checks a condom's physical properties and seal integrity. Then, Trojan condoms are packaged and prepared for shipment nationwide.
Now that we saw how they're made, let's see how they're field tested. I'm gonna show you a film made by the U.S. Army on BD. I bet my dad saw this film.
The film you are about to see is a simple and forward account of the effects of venereal disease, which may result from illicit sexual intercourse. If our country is to successfully defend our right to live the American way, it needs every one of you and requires you in the best possible condition. Any soldier who willfully or through neglect fails to maintain his body in this condition is a shirker who is throwing an extra burden on his comrades by requiring them to do his work as well as their own. The government is vitally interested in having you return to civil life with a better and stronger body than when you entered the Army. This will ensure your preparedness for a successful civilian career and provide our nation with healthy and vigorous citizens to carry it safely through the critical years which lie ahead.
Obviously, this film is shown to you not only for the benefit of your own personal good health, but for that of your entire unit. Lights out.
As an officer of the Army Medical Corps, I wish to bring your attention to an important phase in the preservation of your health. The Army recognizes the risks present with a large number of men in the satisfaction of their sexual impulse. The greatest risk is that of venereal diseases acquired during the sexual act. You will ordinarily not contract sexual diseases if there is no sexual act performed. In that respect, continence, if not total abstinence, is the best of all preventives. However, in the event of contact with a contaminated woman, you must bear in mind that there are available to you, through your own medical corps, specific preventives and cures. Do not permit yourself to be treated by a quack or druggist. They will do you more harm than good. This man is taking not only his own life and sanity in his hands, but is endangering the health of all of his associates by not reporting to his own medical officer for treatment. I will now show you how you can avoid getting any of these diseases in the first place. If you have sexual intercourse, there are two things you must do. First, keep something between you and the germs of venereal disease by using a good rubber. They should be purchased preferably from an Army post exchange. or if this is impossible, from a reliable drugstore. Rubber prophylactic should be free from holes, blisters, air bubbles, and all other defects in material or workmanship. Roll it up. Roll it onto the penis. When you are through, unroll the rubber. You must now do these things as quickly as possible. First, urinate. Pass your water. Second, wash your hands, your penis, and the surrounding skin and hair thoroughly with soap and water. Third, get to the nearest prophylactic station for a treatment. Every minute is important. There is no sure method of preventing venereal disease if you expose yourself to it. These methods will prevent most infections if taken soon enough and performed thoroughly enough. In closing, let me emphasize, it is extremely important that you do not go on a drinking party and allow yourself to become so drunk that you get careless. Drunkenness is responsible for much venereal disease. Since a drunken soldier loses his judgment and becomes the victim through his own failure to take the precautions recommended to him by the medical corps of the United States Army. Men, you are a part of the greatest army in the world. To become soldiers in the first place, you had to have a strong body, health, and common sense. The purpose of this film has been to show you how to keep your health, preserve your body, and to help maintain the great esprit de corps of your organization. It is hoped that you will use your good common sense and continue to be good soldiers and citizens in the service of your country. Do not think that you are the lucky one to go on unscathed. Germs know no distinction between one man and another.
What's so hard about using a condom? I'm gonna use it on a banana. You might want to try it at home. Now remember, there are all different sizes. You might want to try a plantain, number two pencil, whatever size you like. Anyhow, here it goes. It's just as simple as that. It'll only take you a second. A bonita banana. Look at the size of this condom. So it'll handle anything if you're hung like a horse. You know, we'll take care of you. Safety first. Would you rather do this or end up like this?
View, we see Dr. Stein treating penile condylomata acuminata, human papilloma virus. Two methods are used to treat condyloma. The first is primarily used for small warts. These are vaporized with the fiber held in close proximity to the tissue. The goal is to vaporize the wart without causing deep damage. The forward scatter of the laser is used to coagulate the surface slightly below the wart itself. It has been shown that human papillomavirus grow primarily in the epidermis and in the skin appendages. Therefore, it is necessary to coagulate only a millimeter into the dermis. An annular area 1/2 centimeter around the surgical site is also treated. The second treatment method is used for larger, more exophytic warts. Large warts can be vaporized, but it is faster to grasp the wart with pickups and excise it at the base. In comparison to the KTP 532 laser, the carbon dioxide laser does not coagulate deep enough to kill all the virus. The neodymium YAG laser penetrates too deeply and can cause severe scarring.
Venereal warts on that guy look like trail mix dick. This is what happened to our unprotected banana. You know, I don't think it looks that bad.
And crunchy.
And you know, a good joke never gets old. This is how a Dundalk girl eats a banana.
Kelly shows how that Dundalk girl eats a banana again. You feel safe now.
Do you have a towel?
Yes.
So remember, guys, let's be safe. Love is a battlefield. Wear your helmet, or you're gonna be coming back in a body bag.
Don't forget, put it on before you put it in.
Okay.
Thanks for watching Let's Be Safe. I'm Stella Gambino. Peace. Love.